I'm Kelly, and I'm from BrainReach North. I'm here today at McGill University to give you a lesson about the brain. So this is a brain. Specifically, it's a cow brain. Have you ever seen an animal brain before? Maybe a rabbit or a seal's brain? Or maybe you've seen a picture of an animal or even a human brain in a textbook or on the internet. Lots of things look the same across different kinds of animal brains. If you want to learn more about how different animals' brains are similar or different, you can check out the BrainReach North activity, Brain Sizes. So today we're going to do a dissection. Dissection just means that we're going to carefully cut up a biological thing, in this case a cow brain, so that we can study its parts. So this cow brain came from a butcher, and we prepared it by soaking it in a chemical called formaldehyde. So that just keeps it from decomposing and makes it firm enough that we can actually handle it. So let's get started. These thin layers on the top of the brain are called meninges. In a living animal, there are three of them: the dura mater, which is thicker, and the arachnoid and the pia mater, which you can see here. So they help protect the brain. In a living animal or person, a liquid called cerebrospinal fluid fills up the space between the meninges and the brain to help cushion the brain. Looking at the brain from above, we can see the dorsal or top view. This is the front, or rostral end, and this is the back, or caudal end. You can see two halves of the brain, which are called the cerebral hemispheres. The outer layer of the cerebral hemispheres, the part you can see now, is called the cortex. The cortex is covered in bumps called gyri, and grooves called sulci. The different bumps and grooves divide up the cortex into different parts of the brain called lobes. Here at the back, you can see the cerebellum. Cerebellum means little brain. It's called that because it looks like a small version of the whole brain. The cerebellum helps control movement. You can also see a little bit of the brain stem, which connects the brain to the spinal cord. Now we are looking at the brain from the side. This is called a sagittal view. Do you remember how we said that the bumps and grooves divide the brain up into lobes? Well, the front part here is called the frontal lobe, the top part is called the parietal lobe, the back part here is the occipital lobe, and the part along the side here is the temporal lobe. Okay, now it's time to take a look at the inside of the brain. First, we're going to very carefully cut the brain into two halves right down the middle like this. Let's see what we have here. The part right here is called the corpus callosum. It is a thick bundle of nerve fibers connecting the two cerebral hemispheres. The empty space here and here are called ventricles. They're normally filled with cerebrospinal fluid too. CSF is made of the ventricles. There are four ventricles, and we can see two in this view. Now we're going to cut one of these pieces of the brain in half the other way. We call this a coronal cut. Inside, you can see these darker structures. This is called the basal ganglia. Basal ganglia are important for a lot of things, including movement, learning, habits, and emotion. Here we can see the corpus callosum again in the middle. We can also see the white matter, where brain cells from inside the brain are sending signals up to the gray matter on the outside of the brain. That outside layer of gray matter is called the cortex. We can also see the thalamus, which collects information from your five senses and sends it to the rest of the brain. Now I'm going to cut the other side of the brain to see what we can see. So on this cut, again we can see part of the basal ganglia. And then down here, this curly structure is called the hippocampus. The brain has two hippocampi, one on the right and one on the left. The hippocampus is very important for memory. So now I'm going to dissect out the thalamus so we can see the hippocampus better. In this view, you can see how the hippocampus is a long tube that goes from the temporal lobe and then sends fibers up to project to the rest of the brain. Let's recap what we learned. This is the outside of the brain. The side view is called a sagittal view. We call the front of the brain the rostral part, and the back the caudal part. At the caudal end, the cerebellum is below the cerebral hemispheres. This would be just at the back of your neck, right where it meets your head. The brainstem connects the brain to the spinal cord and sends nerves down to your body. Here are the four lobes of the brain. The frontal lobe is at the front, the parietal lobe is on top, the occipital lobe at the back, and the temporal lobes along the sides. When we cut the brain in half sagittally, you can see the corpus callosum, which connects the two cerebral hemispheres, so the left and right parts of your brain can talk to each other. You can also see two of the ventricles, empty spaces that are usually filled with cerebrospinal fluid, and the cerebellum at the back. Next, we cut the brain in half coronally. Here we can see the corpus callosum again in the middle. We can also see the white matter, where brain cells from inside the brain are sending signals up to the gray matter on the outside of the brain. That outside layer of gray matter is called the cortex. We can also see the basal ganglia, which is important in movement and emotion, and the thalamus, which collects information from your five senses and sends it to the rest of the brain. A little further back in the brain, in the bottom of the temporal lobe, we can see the hippocampus. This little structure is important for memory. Here it is in its usual place in the brain, and here we've dissected it out so you can see it a little better.
Thanks for watching! If you have any questions about what you saw in the cow brain or what's going on in your own brain, send us an email at brainreachnorth@gmail.com.